Hello, my dear students. So now coming back to our topic, linear equations in two variables. Word problems, we have finished with the word problems of based on the geometrical figures, formulas, properties of the geometrical figures. And now we will go to another type of problems that are basically dependent on or based on articles. They can be any articles like tables, chairs, books, textbooks, tickets of the picture tickets, movie tickets, balcony tickets, stall tickets. There are two different type of articles, two different type of items, and then based on that the questions are there. Of course here you have to be very strong with your unitary method, the unitary method of yours. Let us see. I have given you the questions based on that. First question, if you'll see, they are telling that I have some analog wrist watches and some digital wrist watches. So basically here there are two different items. One is analog wrist watch and digital wrist watch. I hope you know the meaning of the two. Digital wrist watch is normally that will have digits in it, only digits, no hands. Like analog wrist watch has hands on it. Not to go in detail in that. So there are two types of watches: analog wrist watch and digital wrist watch. I'm going to sell them at a discount rate. See, he's selling the wrist watch also and the analog wrist watch also and the digital wrist watch also. Both of them he's selling at some discount rate. Sale of the first day, analog watches, 11 watches sold, and digital 6 watches were sold. Received amount rupees 4330. Total amount is 330. Now here on second day also the same story, but of course the story in the sense, number of wrist watches sold were 22 and digital watches sold are 5, and then the total amount they received is 7330. Normally what happens over here, the number of the wrist watches are different. What will stay same is the price of the wristwatch. And they have asked us to find the selling price of wristwatch of each type. See, my dear students, here what you are supposed to do is that you have to know the connection between the quantity of the items sold and the price of the item. You have to know the relation between them. Now on the first day they have told analog wrist watches sold are 11 and digital wrist watches sold are 6. That is what they are telling. And total, but while, see, that's what is the difference. While giving you the detail of the wrist watches, they are giving you the quantity. They are giving you the quantity of analog wristwatch and quantity of digital wristwatch. But while giving the total, at that time they are giving you the total amount received. Total amount received is how much? 4330. This is the total amount received. But while giving you, they are not giving the amount received from analog wristwatch, they are giving you the quantity of the analog wristwatch and quantity of the digital wristwatch, not the quantity or amount received from digital wristwatch. Now how do you make them all uniform? See, basically when you are adding the wristwatches, so you should add the wristwatches, and then total wristwatches sold are 17, but that is not getting connected to the amount received. So you have to know, to get the total amount received, you have to know the total amount received from the analog wristwatch and the total amount received from the digital wristwatch. Amount of the wristwatches, amount received from analog wristwatch plus amount received from digital wristwatch is the total amount received. This is the connection. This 4330 is the amount received. But this is the amount you received in what way? When you got the amount received from the analog wristwatch and the amount means money that you received from after selling analog wristwatches, some money came to you. After selling digital wristwatches, some money came to you, and the total money you added, that is 4,330. But you don't know what is the amount received after selling, or the money received after selling analog wristwatches, or the money received after selling digital wristwatches. This you are not sure about, because you, now what is that? How do you calculate that? How do you come to know that the money received after selling analog wristwatches was how much? Now what is that you need to know? See, if I tell you that the cost of this marker is 12 rupees, one marker, and then what will be the cost of 10 markers? Cost of one marker is equal to 12 rupees, fine. Cost price of 10 markers will be how much? You will multiply the rate by the quantity. Rate is always one marker ka, it is the rate. So one marker 12 rupees, that is the rate of the marker, and that 12 when you multiply by the quantity 10, then you will come to know that the cost price of 10 markers will be 12 into 10, 120 rupees. You are multiplying this quantity with the number of markers with the cost of one marker. Are you getting? For that you have to know the cost price of one marker. Do you know the cost price of analog watch or the digital watch? You don't know. Basically that is what you are supposed to calculate. So here what you will have to tell is that let the cost price of one analog wristwatch be equal to rupees X. You don't know what that is. And let the cost price of one digital watch be equal to rupees Y. Now you know that the cost of one analog watch is X. Like here it would have been one marker is 12. Now you are selling how many? One day, first day you are selling 11 watches, quantity of 11 watches. Therefore, cost price or amount received. Therefore, amount received after selling 11 analog watches will be how much? See, one watch is X rupees. 11 watches will be 11 into the rate of the watch, rupees 11x. Similarly, amount received after selling how many digital watches? Six digital watches is equal to how much they will be now? Digital watch. One digital watch is costing Y rupees. Y into 6. 6Y. This is the amount that they have received after selling 6 digital watches. After selling 11 digital watches. And total amount they have told is how much? 4,330. That means this amount and this amount, total amount is going to be 4,330. So according to given information, what they are telling, this amount 11x plus 6y is equal to 4,330. That is all. This is going to be your first equation. Okay, my dear students. Now we go to the next equation. Similarly, in the next table, they have told that the number of analog watches quantity over here is 22 and digital watch quantity is 5. Quantity is 22, quantity is 5, and the money received from these two is 7,330. I hope the figures are right. 7,330, that is the money received. So again the same condition, it will be rate is going to be same. The rate of the analog watches on the first day was same and the second day was same. They are not changing the rate of the watches. So next day also, the second day, this is needed, not needed actually, but still, second day amount received after selling how many analog watches? 22 analog watches. What was the amount received? Will be 22 into x rupees 22x. Similarly, amount received after selling, how many are there? 5 digital watches is equal to rupees. Oh, 5 into y, 5y. I hope you all are getting this. Now you know that amount from here is 22x rupees, amount from here is 5y rupees. This is one quantity, this is one, not quantity, this is one value, one number, amount. This amount plus this amount is the total amount, and total amount they have told that they have received is 7,330. So you get here, according to information given, you will get that this 22x plus this 5y is going to be 7,330. So in this way you have got two linear equations, and now you know how to solve these two linear equations. So if I go to equate them, so I'll have to multiply the first equation by 2. So I'll write over here, multiplying . So what do I get? 2 into 11x plus 6y is equal to 4,330. This will become 22x plus 26 are 12y. This is going to be a third equation. Now you will see your this second equation and third equation, they have got equated. But then what are you going to do? Add the two equations or subtract the two equations? Definitely will subtract the two equations because the signs are same. So you will write over here, so otherwise 3 from 2, remember that. So you will get 22x plus 5y, 22x plus 12y. Of course you are going to subtract that, so you will have to leave a line over here. This will become plus, will become minus, plus will become minus, plus will become minus. These both are gone. 5 minus 12y will give you 7y. Sign of the greater number minus. Here also there will be sign of the greater number, but here you will be getting 0, 3. I am imagining it down. You will subtract in that way. 6 minus 3 will be 3, 6 minus 3 will be 3. 8 minus 7 will be 1, minus sign. So now what you get over here, I am continuing over here, y is equal to minus 1330 upon minus 7. So this will become y is equal to 7, 1's are 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 6, 7, 9's are 63, 0, 190. This is the cost of 1 digital watch, and then you will substitute this value y is equal to 190 in any of these equations 1, 2, or 3. So substituting y is equal to 190 in equation 1, what is equation 1? 11x plus plus
6y
is equal to
4330. So you get 11x plus 6
into what is y?
190. 4330. So 11x is equal to 4330 minus, this is getting multiplied, 6 9s are 54, 1240.
No, 1140. So this I'll subtract. When I subtract this, 4330 minus 11409, okay, is right. Okay, so this will become 3190. So x is equal to 3190 upon 11, 2s are 22, then again 90. So analog watches are costlier than digital watches. So cost price of one analog watch is equal to rupees 290. Cost price of one digital watch is equal to rupees 190. So this is how we have solved it. Now we can go to the next question. Okay, I'll try using this marker. Now in the second question, if you'll see the two items here given are, two boxes of type A and B are placed in a truck having capacity of 10 tons. Okay, capacity of the truck is 10 ton. So that is basically 1 ton is how many? 1000 kgs make 10, 1000 kgs make a ton, 1 ton. So 10 tons is the capacity of the truck. So how many kgs will it take? 10,000 kgs will be the capacity of the truck. That is now the weight they are talking about. Now when they are talking about the weight. See the things, how they are going to be correlated. That is very much important. Capacity of the truck they have given in tons. 10 tons, that is 10,000 kg is the capacity of the truck. They have told when 150 boxes of type A and 100 boxes of type B are loaded in the truck, it weighs 10 tons. While giving, they are giving you the quantity of the boxes. Quantity of box A is 150 and quantity of box B is 100. That time the weight becomes 10 tons, means exactly what is the capacity of the truck. See, same thing will happen. Here what happens? Price, rate, then the rate amount received from the analog watches is rate of watch multiplied by the quantity of watch will give you the amount received by the watch. Now in this case, what are they doing is that they are talking about the weight. So if we know the weight of one box A, weight of one box A. So if now we know that the weight of one box A, then the 10 boxes of A will be what? The weight of 10 boxes of A will be one, weight of one box multiplied by 10 will give you the weight of 10 boxes. Same like that only. But except that here there is rate, over here there is weight. And of course you should know the conversion. 10 tons basically is equal to 10,000 kgs. Because see, we have to convert them into kgs because definitely the box A, one box A will be not in the tons. One box A or box B will be in kgs. So we will have to convert tons also to kgs. So same thing will happen, my dear students over here. What you have to do is, see here, second question, let weight of one box of A be equal to x kg. We don't know what is the weight of that box. Same, x kg, and here let weight of one box of B be equal to y kg. Okay, so weight from one box of A is 1 kg, x kg, one box of B is y kg. Now they have told, in first case there are how many boxes? There are 150 boxes of type A. So weight of 150 boxes of A, 150 box, one box x, so 150 box will be 150 x kg. Okay, then weight of next box B is how much? How many are there? 100. Weight of 100 boxes of B is equal to 100 y kg, because weight of one box of B we have taken as y. So weight of one box of B is y. So definitely 100 boxes of B, the weight will be 100 into y, 100 into y. And the total weight they have told is equal to 10 tons. So according to information given, what you will have? 150x plus 100y is equal to 10 tons, but that will be equal to 150x plus 100y is equal to 10,000 kgs. Fine, this will not require to, it's okay, this kg is not required for you to understand. So now here you can reduce this equation. You can reduce this equation, you can definitely divide it by, see 10 se to sab jayega, and then again by 5. You can divide that by 50, I suppose. So dividing throughout by 50, see my dear students, those who are not able to understand how this I got 50, you can just do this. 150x plus 100y is equal to 10,000. Don't worry, you can see there is 0, 0, 0 over here. I'll divide this throughout by 10, so that this goes, this goes, this goes, this goes, this goes, this goes. And then again I have to divide this by 5. So 5, 3s are 15, 5, 2s are 10, 5, 20s are. So here 10 into 5, 50. I got it like this. Okay, so otherwise you can go one step, no problem. Upon 50, upon 50, upon 50. This is gone, this is gone, this is gone. 5, 3s are 15, 5, 2s are 5, 2, 0, 0. This will be your first equation. Okay, yes. Now we go for the next case. In the next case, what will happen is that, in the next case they have told, but when 260 boxes of type A are loaded in the truck, it can still accommodate 40 boxes of type B. Means in the second case, 260 boxes of type A and 40 boxes of type B. So weight of 260 boxes of type A, 260, na? Yes, will be how much now? X, 260 x kg, weight of 40 boxes of type
B will be 40 y kg.
Okay, 40, yeah, yes. So again the story is going to be same, my dear students. 260x, according to the given information, 260x plus 40y is going to be, again it is going to be up to its capacity, 10,000, right? So now I will do what? Again I can divide by 10 10 10 10, and then again I can divide by 2. Yes, 10 10 and 2, 10 2s are 20. So dividing 20, you will get 260x plus 40y is equal to 10,000. This I'll divide by 20, this I'll divide by 20, and this also I'll divide by 20. I ink is, I'll have to refill that. So this will give me what? 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. 2 1s are 2 3s are, that will give me 13x plus 2y is equal to 2 5s are, and then 0 0. This will be my second equation. I hope you all are getting this fine. Now my first equation is this. Already I have got y is equated over there, so no need of multiplying and going to equate the coefficients. They are already equated in the case of y, so I'll just think about whether I have to add them or subtract them. So because the signs of 2y 2y are same, so subtracting, equation 3 from 2. So 13x plus 2y 500 minus 3x plus 2y is equal to 200. Subtracting, I have to leave a line over here. Plus will become minus, plus will become minus, plus will become minus. 2y minus 2y will be cancelled. The 13x minus 3x will give me 10x is equal to 500 minus 200 will give me 300. So I will get x is equal to 300 upon 10. So x is equal to 30. This is the weight of one box of A. Fine. And then substituting, x is equal to 30 in any equation, in equation 1, we get what? 3x plus 2y is equal to 200. In place of x, I'll write 30. 3 into 30 plus 2y is equal to 200. So this is 3, 30s are 90, so 90 goes on the other side. 2y is equal to 200 minus 90. The 2y is equal to 200 minus 90 will give me 110. Fine. So y is equal to how much now? Upon 2, 55. So the last statement will be the weight of one box. But what they have asked you, find the weight of each type of box. That's all. Therefore, weight of box A is x is equal to 30 kg, weight of box B y is equal to 55 kg. You can counter check, my dear students, same way as we have been doing. I should have done the first one also, but I did not counter check. So in the second case, but we'll have to do this. 3x plus 2y is equal to 200. So we have to get 200 when we substitute in the left hand side. 3x plus 2y, this is the case. Remember, you have to, while verification, whether when we have to counter check whether our answer is right, at that time you have to take only the left hand side, 3x plus 2y, and then substitute the values of 3x plus 2y. 3 into x is 30 plus 2 into y is 55. So 330 is 90 25 is at 10, 25 is at 11. If I add these two, I'll get 200. That is the case. Right hand side has come. So this answer is right in this case. If I go for the second case, second equation is 13x plus 2y. So 13x plus 2y. I will definitely not take the right hand side. Right hand side is, I have to get that. So in place of x, I'll write 13 into what is the value of x? 30. 2 into what is the value of y? 55. This I will multiply. 49, 110. Again, if I add these all, 500. That is the right hand side. So that is the case, my dear students. So we have got both the questions. So if you want, you can take down this. Take a screenshot of this if you feel. I'll tour up this all. Okay, my dear students. So going forward. So if we see the next question, the next question deals with Kantabai bought 1.5 kg of tea and 5 kg of sugar. Again, my dear student, there are two different articles, the two different items over here. And what are the items over here? The tea and sugar. And what is she telling is that she paid rupees 50 as return fare. So while buying this 1.5 kg of tea and 5 kg of sugar, whatever is the cost she paid over there, total cost she paid over there, plus you have to take the rupees 50 fare that she had paid for the rickshaw. Total expense was, again the same case, my dear students. For total expense, like this, what we had done for the first question. For the total expense, first you should know the rate of the sugar per kg. If you note the rate of the kg, sugar per kg, then you can find the money required to buy 1.5 kg of sugar. 1.5 kg of sugar plus 1.5 kg of tea, 1.5 kg of tea plus 5 kg of sugar will give you the total value of the grocery taken. Fine. But then add plus 50 over there, and then that is going to be the total value is going to be 700. Next month she realizes that online will be slightly cheaper. She doesn't have to pay the transport charges over there. So she ordered online for 2 kg of tea and 7 kg of sugar. She paid rupees 880. Find the rate of sugar and tea per kg. We have to travel in the same way, my dear students. See, try to understand. First of all, what you have to understand is that the relation between what are the two things that are related over here. In the first case also, the rate of the wristwatch, rate of one wristwatch multiplied by 11 will give you the price of 11 wristwatches. You should know the rate of one wristwatch. That rate multiplied by the quantity will give you the money received from the 11 watches. Rate of one digital watch, and then how many digital watches were sold? 6. So 6 multiplied by rate of one digital watch will give you the money received by 6 digital watches. Same was the case in the second case, boxes. Weight of one box, you should know the weight of one box, which is unknown to you. Rate of one box and then multiplied by 150 will give you the weight of 150 boxes. Similar over here, you have to know the rate of 1 kg of tea 1 kg of sugar, then you will know the value of 1.5 kg of tea and 5 kg of sugar. But in the first case, what they have done is that they have added even the 50 rupees of the transportation that we have to take care again. So here what we get is that rate of 1 kg of sugar and tea. Okay.
Rate of 1 kg tea be equal to rupees X. Let rate of 1 kg sugar be equal to rupees Y.
Fine. I hope you all are able to see that. I'll write something bolder. So this is the rate of 1 kg of tea, 1 kg of sugar. But what she has done in the first case, first time she has bought 1.5 kg of tea. Therefore,
cost price of 1.5 kg tea will be what? X into 1.5, right? X into 1.5, that will be 1 rupees 1.5 X. Are you getting? X into 1.5, these two you have to multiply. X into 1.5 X rupees. And similarly, cost price of how much sugar she has bought in the first case? 5 kg. 5 kg sugar will be equal to, again now this time what? Y and 5. Rupees 5 Y. This will be the cost price of sugar, 5 kg sugar. But then she has again added transport charges. So according to the information given, what do we get? 1.5x plus 5y plus 50 is equal to how much they have given? 700. This is going to be 700. Okay, the 1.5, this 50 goes on the other side. I'll get 1.5x plus 5y is equal to 700 goes on, 700 is there, minus 50, so that will give me 1.5x plus 5y is equal to 650.
If you are not very happy with the decimal, so see, decimal basically 1.5x means basically it is, if I remove the decimal, I'll get 10. Fine. If I remove, there is one decimal, so this, remove one decimal, I'll take 10 in the denominator. Wherever the decimal is, if the decimal is in the denominator, how many decimal places are there? That many zeros you add in the numerator, and then the decimal can go off. Similarly, if the decimal is in the numerator, how many decimal places are there in the numerator? That many zeros you add in the denominator, decimal will go off. So here there is one decimal in the numerator. So to remove this one decimal from the numerator, I put 10 in the denominator. But then to remove this decimal, this denominator, what I will have to do? Multiply throughout by 10. Are you getting? So I'll just multiply throughout by 10. I will not write everything over here. I'll just tell multiplying. You can even think about multiplying from here itself. I'll get 10 into 1.5x plus 5y is equal to 650. So if I multiply now, 1.5 into 10 will give me 15x, 50y. This will give me 6500, and this is going to be my first equation. Okay, so in this way I got the first equation. So I hope you all are able to see this. The format font is large enough. and light larger. Every time I'm thinking that I should write larger. But now in the second case, what she is doing, next month she placed order online for 2 kg of tea and 7 kg of sugar. Now because this is coming to her home directly, so there is no transport charges involved. 2 kg of tea and 7 kg sugar. So here, cost price of 2 kg tea will be how much now? 2 multiplied by x, rupees 2x, and then cost price of 7 kg sugar, yeah, that is going to be rupees 7y. This time there is no transport charges, so this she has paid according to information given, or the given information, 2x plus 7y. This time she is paying how much? 880. Total is 880. So this is, well, can I think about converting them? Oh, this is going to be not that easy. So what? Nothing. Cross multiply, you'll have to multiply both the equations. You can't multiply 2 by anything to get 15. You can't multiply 7 by anything to get 50. So you'll have to multiply both the figures. So it's better we'll go for x, multiplying equation 1. Equation 1 by what? The opposite is 2. 2. Sorry, we get, so 2 into 15x plus 50y is equal to 6500. This will give you 215, the 30x, 100y, 13000. Fine. And the second case, what you will do, multiply second equation by 15. So 15 into, what is the second equation? 2x plus 7y is equal to 880. This will give me 2x, 30x, 7, 5s are 35, 7, 8, 9, 10, 105. Y now is the case. Fine. Now this is going to be 880. 13,200. 13,200, this is going to be your fourth equation. So now your equations have equated, and again they have got the same signs, subtracting equation 4 from 3. So third is 30x plus 100y, 30x plus is equal to 13,000, and this will give you 30x plus 105y. If I subtract these two, leave one line, plus will become minus, plus will become minus, plus will become minus. These both are gone. 100 minus 105 will give you minus 5y. 13,000 minus 200. Y will be equal to minus 200 upon. Minus 5 will go over there. So y is equal to 5. 4s are 20, 0. So you have got the y. value of y is equal to 40, means rate of sugar is 40 rupees per kg. Okay, so now substituting,
y is equal to 40 in equation
1, yeah, 2, 2 is better. What is 2? 2x
plus 7y is equal to 880. So 2x plus 7 into 40. So this will give you 2x plus 80. So 2x is equal to 880 minus 280. So this will give you 2x is equal to 600. 300 rupees per kg.
So tea is quite costly. Fine. So, but we'll have to counter check that. So if I go to counter check, verification needed. First equation is this:
15x plus 50y. 15.
What is my x? 300.
50.
What is my y? 40. Okay, in place of x, I've substituted the value of x. In place of y, value of y. So this will give me
15 into 15, 3 is 45, and then double 0. This is 5, 4 is 20, and then again double 0. But if I add this 20,000, 4,000, 6,500.
6,500. The first equation is verified. Going for the second equation.
2x plus 7y. 2x plus 7y. What is the value of x? 300. What is the value of y? 40. Sorry, 7 into 40. This will give me 600. 7, 4 are 28, 280. If I add those both, I'll get 880.
That is right. Fine. So verification is done. So I'll write over here. Therefore, rate of sugar
is equal to, what is sugar?
Y,
rupees 40 per kg. Rate of T is equal to rupees 300 per kg.
Okay, so in this way we have done this question number 2, no sorry, question number 3. Now let us go forward for question number 4. Fine. Question number 4. Here the, what are the items? A coach of a cricket team buys 3 bats and 6 balls for rupees 3,900. Again, now here there are called the 2 different items are bat and ball. So let us see, represent this situation algebraically and geometrically. See, there, here they have only asked you to draw the equations algebraically and geometrically. Only they have asked you to represent the situations algebraically and geometrically. See, when you have to represent the equation, means they have not asked you to find the value of the bat. They have not asked you to find the cost of the bat or the cost of the each ball. They have just asked you to represent them algebraically. Algebraically is this, what we have done. The moment you have written them in equation form, this is you have written them in the algebraic form. Geometrical form, that means you will have to draw this graph. The moment you draw the graph, you have represented it in the geometrical form. Draw the graph and leave it. The moment you will draw both the graphs, you will get the solution, because you know that the intersection point of the two graphs is the solution. But they have not asked you the solution. You can just tell, if you want, the solution of the two graphs is so and so. We can get the cost price of bat and ball is so and so. We can get, just leave it over there. But that is not asked. They have only asked you to algebraically represent. So when they ask you that much, you'll just tell over here, bat and ball, let
cost price of each bat rupees X, let cost price of each ball be equal to rupees Y.
So in first case, what he has done? 3 bats, 6 balls. Now, my dear students, you can understand 3 bats and 6 balls. You can directly write this.
According to first information,
what will you get? He has taken how much? 3 bats. Now, you know 3 bats will cost you 3x rupees.
3x.
And how many balls? 6 balls. Then they will cost you 6y rupees. 3 bats will cost you 3x rupees. 6 balls will cost you 6y rupees. If you add these two, this total is going to, he has told that it is 3900. This is actually the value is 3900. You can reduce it further. Just divide throughout by 2. No, 3. 3 is better. You can divide throughout by 3. So this will give you x plus 2y. Oh no, they have told you to algebraically represent. So no, this is algebraical representation. This is algebraic representation of the first one. You need not go to reduce it because you are not going to solve it. For that case of 3 bats and 6 balls, this is the algebraic representation. Fine. So and the second case, what are they telling? Later she buys another bat. Another bat means one more bat and 3 more balls. So one bat means x and 3 balls means 3y. This time the total is how much? 1300 rupees. This is the algebraic the equation 1 and equation 2 are the algebraic representation of the given examples. So what do you tell?
Equation 1 and equation 2 are the algebraic representation of given examples.
Fine. And now they want it to be graphically represented. So for graphical representation, again you will do the same thing from the equation 1.
From equation 1, 3x plus 6y is equal to 3900. You will divide this throughout by 3. X plus 2y is equal to 1300.
So now you have to get the values, the table and everything. So you have to get one variable on one side. So x I'll keep on the one side, I'll get x is equal to 1300 minus 2y. So I'll make a table over here of 4 columns, 3 rows. So now I'll go to find the value of y. I'll have to take big values. I can take x, y as 100. If I take y as 100, so 100 also will not help. 500. This will be huge figures. On the scale also, algebraic representation also, you will not be able to take the values of 0, 1, 2, 3. अच्छा फंसाया। यू विल हैव टू टेक द वैल्यूज ऑफ 0 टू 1 सेंटीमीटर विल बी योर सपोज मीन्स 500, 1000, 1500, लाइकवाइज यू विल हैव टू टेक दोज ग्राफ पेपर। सी माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इफ आई टेक y इज इक्वल टू 1, x विल गो इन द वैल्यू ऑफ थाउजेंड्स। आर यू गेटिंग? इफ आई टेक y इज इक्वल टू 10, स्टिल इट विल गो इन द वैल्यू ऑफ थाउजेंड्स एंड ऑल। इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू हेल्प यू इन दैट वे। सो हियर वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ y? फॉर y इज इक्वल टू, इन फर्स्ट केस आई कैन गो फॉर 500, बिकॉज 500 टू 10 विल गिव मी 1000, सो आई विल गेट x इज इक्वल टू 1300 माइनस 2 इंटू, इट विल टेक माई होल स्पेस, इट्स ओके, फॉरगेट, आई विल हैव टू डू इट प्रॉपरली अदरवाइज आई डोंट वॉन्ट यू गेट कन्फ्यूज। फॉर y इज इक्वल टू 500, सो वॉट इज द फिगर? x इज इक्वल टू 1300 माइनस 2y, x इज इक्वल टू 1300 माइनस 2 इंटू 500, x इज इक्वल टू 1300 माइनस 1000, ना नाउ आई गॉट 1000, सो आई विल गेट x इज इक्वल टू 300। आर यू गेटिंग? सो x इज इक्वल टू 300, आई होप दिस यू हैव अंडरस्टूड, x इज इक्वल टू 300 फॉर y इज इक्वल टू 500। आर यू गेटिंग? द दिस ऑल्सो इज गोइंग टू बी स्मॉल फॉर मी नाउ, 300, 500, फाइन। नाउ आई गो टू द नेक्स्ट केस, इफ आई गो फॉर y is equal to 0, if I take, then I will get x is equal to 1300. 1300 will not be that easy for me to locating over there. 1000 I got, now what next? 500. If I take it to be 1000, 2000, minus 300, still it will be slightly problematic, but still. I will have to take that risk. See here, for y is equal to 0, x is equal to 1300 minus 2y, x is equal to 1300 minus 2 into 0, x is equal to 1300 I get. So this is 1300 when y is equal to 0, 1300 is 0, fine. Now I go for the another figure, another will be what? If I go for taking it to be 2300, I'll have to take that 2000 maybe jana padega. See what is the value that I can go for? I can go from here to here. If I go 100 is not going to help me, okay, so I can go for 200 can help me, because you have got a list of 800 at the maximum, 8 on one side, hai na, 8 over there, 8 over here, but that will take you to 1600, and we have gone up to 300, 1300, 1300, and I am talking about taking one more. We can go for that, take a smaller value, this will be 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200 and all, like this you will have to go. So first I will take this x is equal to 1300. Now one more, if I go for positive, negative, if I take 500, 2300, no, it will not be there, so I will have to go for some other value. Y is equal to 500, y is equal to 0, y is equal to supposing 150 I take, 1000 chalega. If I take it, see this 300, I want this 300 to be removed, so if I take y is equal to 150, the 2 into 150 will give me 300, so for y is equal to 150, so it will give me x is equal to 1300 minus 2y, x is equal to 1300 minus 2 into 150, so it will give me x is equal to 1300 minus 300, x is equal to 1300 minus 1000, x is equal to 1000 when y is equal to 150. Fine. Now if I go to plot this, चलेगा इतना 1300 चलेगा, फाइन. This is your 100, 200, 300, 400. Oh, sorry, not 100. 100 is not going to help. 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000. I know you are not able to see this, but you have to understand that. 1200, 1400, and then 1600. Same will be over here on the reverse fashion. Minus 200, minus 400, minus 600, minus 800, minus 1000, minus 1200. Here 200, 400, 600, 800, 1200, 1400. Here again 200, 400, minus 400, minus 600, minus 800, minus 1000, minus 1200, minus 1400. This is going to be a scale now. Now if I go for the first case, x is equal to 300, y is equal to 500. X is equal to 300, it will be between these two. Y is equal to 500, that will be between these two. If these two come anywhere, it should come somewhere over here in this fashion, okay. And this is going to be, for y is equal to 0, x is equal to 1300. So on x axis 1300, that will be between 1200 and 1400, this. And then you have got x is equal to 1000 and 150. 1000, x is equal to 1000 is this, and 150 is going to come between this is 200, iska half is going to be 100, and between 200 and 100 will be 150. So it will be over here somewhere, over here, and with going with 1000. So I go straight from here, I should go straight from here up to 1000. It will come something like that. This will be a graph which is running straight. This will be your graph. This will be the graphical representation. Okay, my dear students. So similarly, you will go for the another graph. X plus 3y is equal to 1300. So for that, what we will do? Again, the same thing. X plus 3y is equal to 1300. Again, I will make a table over here of four columns and three rows. This is x, this is y, and this is x comma y. So of course here I should have taken that x is equal to 1300 minus 3y. So same thing, my dear students. For in first case, what I'll do, I'll take y is equal to 100. 100 into 3, 300, so that will get cancelled. For y is equal to 100, I will get x is equal to 1300 minus, see, 100 into 3, 300, x is equal to 1000, I will get x is equal to 1000 when y is equal to 100. If I go for the second case, what I will take, y is equal to 0,300 I'll get. Okay. 1300 I'll get. I can go for y is equal to 300 I took. 300 I'll take 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, 4. That's okay. So y is equal to 300. What I'll get? X is equal to 1300 minus 3 into 300. X is equal to 1300 minus 3, 3 is 900. 400 I'll get. Are you getting? So X is equal to, for X is equal to 400. For when? When Y is equal to 300. This is the case. Okay. And of course I can take 0. No problem. For Y is equal to 0. X is equal to 1300. Fine. This 1300 plotting, 1300 is can be slightly difficult, or you can take any other value also. So here what we get for y is equal to 0, x is equal to 1300. So what we get over here is, first case 1000 and 100. 1000 here, 100 is going to be below this. Is going to be below this, exactly half of this. This is your 1100. That 400 and 300. 400 is this, and 300 will be between 200 and 400. Something over here. Fine. And then we have got 1300 on x-axis. So that is what here is. This is the same one. So this line will go something like this. So this will be your graphical representation. Understood? And if they ask you to solve it, then you will have to solve this two. Just multiply the second equation by 3 and you will be able to solve and get it. Okay? But at present they are just asking you to represent them algebraically. Algebraic representation is this. The equations are the algebraic representation. Equation 1 and equation 2 are the algebraic representation of given examples. Graphical representation, you will have to draw the graph. Write it in the end. So the above is the graphical representation of the given examples. The intersection point over here, how can that be? Something has gone wrong, my dear students. Right, but still the answer is coming right. The answer is coming right, but I am not, it's not justified. How can the cost price of, see, x is what? Cost price of each bat is 1300 you are getting, and cost price of each ball is 0, means ball is coming for free. But if you substitute the values, they are coming right. That can be the condition. Chalo, first. Okay. So going to the next one, 5, 6, 7. It's too late. It's too late, my dear students. So I think we'll have to stop over here. There are 3 more questions that we have to solve. We'll solve them tomorrow. Okay, my dear students. I hope you all have enjoyed the lecture, understood it very nicely. Take down this. Thank you very much.